The angel of the Lord called to Abraham the second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you. And I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies. And by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, and with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden, and the path and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of meeting. For all the boots of the tramping warriors, and all the garments rolled in blood, shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Isaiah. A shoot shall come out from the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall lie with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in his hands of blood and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the Gospel of Luke. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over the flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I'm bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in this city of David the Savior, who is the Messiah the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth lying in a manger." And suddenly there was the angel, multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is this child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and we've come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him, and calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may go also and take him home.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and they paid him homage. They opened their treasure chests. They offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. from the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God, and all things came to being through Him. And without Him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in Him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light, the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yes, the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or the will of the flesh, or the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Word of the Lord.
Thank you. Good and loving God, in this holy season of Advent, we are grateful for the opportunity to wait. For it is in waiting that we may pause to become aware, in the present moment, of the world around us. It is in waiting that we may turn inward and tend to the things we have left untended. Those places and parts of our hearts and minds that simply need rest. It is in waiting that we become open to the possibility of something new. In this holy season, the earth herself goes to sleep. The ground is blanketed with cold and quiet, and rather than pushing for more growth and productivity, the plants and trees release their leaves, put down their burdens, and rest. And as the nights grow longer, we too are called to rest and to wait. In waiting, we may reflect on the year that has passed, on things achieved and things we wish had been different, on the friendships we have formed and those that may need repairing. In recent months, our world has been shaken with far too much pain and suffering. And we pray for the many people who have been impacted by violence and hate. We know that God weeps with us who weep and who mourn. But in waiting, there is also hope. Hope in the anticipation of new life. Hope in the possibility of renewal. Hope in the recognition that God is with us, even in the darkest night. Hope in the light of the Advent candle that shines in that silent night as we wait in joyful anticipation of the coming of God, not as a mighty warrior, but in the form of an innocent child. We pray now that we may rest in the heavenly peace that is the gift of this holy season. And may the peace of God that surpasses all understanding be among you and remain with you all, always. Amen.
light. It is dark, but we are not in darkness. It is indeed night, but we see the coming of the dawn. In the season of waiting, the sacred Advent time, go from this place, warmed by hope, sustained by God's peace, sheltered by the joy of our Lord, held by the radical love of our Christ. Amen.